Okay, so I just thought I'd do a quick bonus video on how to set up the user interface to your own particular requirements. This is what the user interface of OpticStudio looks like when you first open it, and I'm just going to load a file now to actually have something in the editor. Now, this is the OpticStudio default settings. I usually like to change them, and particularly for this YouTube video, I change quite a bit so that it's more visible if you're looking at this on a tablet, a phone or something like that. The first thing I do is I go to the lens data editor. Now, this series of videos is going to be about optimizing the basic shapes. And as a result, I'm not going to be using all of the columns that the lens data editor shows by default. In particular, I'm not going to use the conic columns because I won't use that for doing A-spheres. I'm not going to use the coating columns because we're not going to be looking at transmission. I'm not going to use the chip zone or mechanical semi-diameter because we won't be looking at productionizing the edges of the lenses yet. And I won't be looking at the thermal coefficient of expansion because I'm not going to be doing thermal analysis yet. We'll do all of those in subsequent videos, but I don't need them right now. So what I'm just going to do is come to the conic column, click on its header so it's the whole column is highlighted, and I'm just going to move it to the other side of the clear semi-diameter, and I'm going to do the same thing with the coating column. I'm just going to take that to the other side of the clear semi-diameter, and then I'm going to click on the column heading where it says coating, and then with the control button pressed, I'm going to also click on conic, chip zone, mechanical semi-diameter, thermal coefficient of expansion, and I'm just going to right mouse click and hide those columns so that, you know, we don't see them. All I'm going to be using in this series of videos is the radius, the thickness, the material, and the semi-diameters, the apertures of the lenses. That's all I'm going to require. I'm now just going to go to the Setup tab and the Project Preferences. Within that setting, I'm going to start off on address. I've already set this to say Design Optics Fast as my YouTube channel's name, and I've already put in the version number of the software. Now, I do think it's a good idea to put the version number of the software in the address so that at any future point when you're looking at something, you can see which version you were running at it. And then there's just the comment, basic shapes optimization that I want to have on these things. If I then go to editors, you can see a number of different things here. The first is the font size, and I'm going to change the font size to something like a 24 point font. And you can see that changes immediately and makes it much, much bigger, easier for you to see on the screen. But the size of the columns hasn't changed. So to change that, I'll set that to 25 also and just set them all to be 25. It's maybe a little bit too much, maybe 20 is going to be enough. And I can do exactly the same with the other windows. I'm going to use the merit function, so I'm going to set that the same, but I won't be using the other editors yet, so I'll just leave them alone. I'm happy with three decimal places being shown, which is controlled here. This does not affect the precision with which the data is held internally. It's purely how it's presented in the editors, and if you enter data to a higher precision, it'll still be shown to the precision required, but I think that's just fine. And I'm going to have my window X size set at 1000 so that when a window opens, it's 1000 pixels wide. Under folders, I am going to make some changes here, and the particular one I'm going to change is that I want to use a different folder for all my lenses. So by default, when you do file open, it opens in the samples folder. I actually have a folder I want to use for these videos, and so I click here, and I'm going to use Google Drive, which is where I keep it, my ZMAX files, and I have a folder called Design Optics Fast, and I've got another folder called Optimizing the Basic Shapes. I just select that as my folder. You can see that you can redefine where all these other folders are, and particularly with the CAD files. It's a really good idea to change these folders on a per customer basis, so you keep all of your customer X files separate to all of your customer Y files. There's a lot of stuff there that you can do that will really enforce a bit of tidiness and a bit of separation between customers. Under general, I'm not actually going to show date. I think you should show the date on all of these things, but I'm not going to, because on YouTube, nothing makes a video look older than having it the date it was made on it. So I'm just going to set that to none. Everything else here is fine. Or I will increase the font size of the text windows as well. And I'll make that about a 20 sized font as well. And you see here, I've got the status bar, which controls these things shown down here. I actually want to change these for the basic shapes series that I'm doing. So I'm happy with effective focal length, but for number two, I would rather have the image space F number. For number three, I want to have the entrance pupil diameter, which is what it is. And for number four, I would like to show the maximum field. So that will change those items down there. Under graphics, I'll use an aspect ratio of 3x4. I can change the fonts. I like this particular Viridis false color. And also, the thing that I change, and I always change it, default export resolution. When you export a window, it picks up the resolution from the size of the window. And on the whole, I don't really want that. So I'm going to choose to use a custom export width of 4K. And the window size, I think I wanted that to be 1,000. Now, toolbar, I'm going to be doing a lot of optimization. Now, let me just move this up to here so that you can see up here we have a toolbar. And I want to put a few things on there specifically because we're going to use them in optimization. So the first thing I'm going to do is put a separator in there. And then I want a couple of the tools that start with quick. So I'll just search on that. I want quick focus. I want quick adjust. I also want the optimization wizard. You'll see there are two of them. And this one will give you the optimization wizard closed, and this one will give it to you open. The only reason I know that is I did both and found that out. So you actually want the second optimization wizard, and I'll just move it that way across. And I'll take also the optimize button and take that across. I think that's everything I wanted to make a change of in here. So I just click OK, and then I come up here to this red button on the toolbar. That's update all, and that will refresh everything with what I've got. Because I like it this way, I'm actually going to save it as Design Optics Fast Project Preferences.cfg so that I can just pick this up anytime I want. And that's that. The last thing I'm going to do is just change the way that windows are laid out. OpticStudio has this fantastic windowing system. Let me just float this out. And then you can add them back into other windows like so, things like that. Now, I don't actually like it. I'm a bit of an old fuddy-duddy and I like to have individual windows. So under window options, I simply go to float all windows, and that's my setting. And I just set them to the right kind of size for me. I just make this a little bigger so you can see clear semi diameter. That's nice, like that. Just make that the right size there. Right, I'm happy with this as a layout. I also don't like to dock new windows, so I have that toggled off. If you want new windows to dock automatically, you can click that and it will stay selected. New windows will be docked. I don't like that. I like to have them undocked. And so let's just say that I open an MTF plot. Then it comes up with all of these settings that I prefer. If I look at the text, I've got a nice large font for you guys who are looking at this on your phones. You look here at the editor, nice big friendly font with lots of room. Just my preferences, just the way I prefer to do things.